Let's talk to Healer Zolas.
Open a channel to Healer Zolas.
Channels open.
I'm Lieutenant Commander Data of the Starship Enterprise. I'm investigating the absence of Dr. Hoon Forsh.
A Starfleet officer. I was expecting this.
You were, huh? Why did you expect Starfleet yet to investigate?
Why did you expect Starfleet to investigate the Doctor's disappearance?
It seemed likely. She said she planned to file a complaint with the Federation Council regarding smuggling in the Preserve.
We received no such report.
The Council received no such report.
Well, then I suppose she changed her mind. Or someone changed it for her.
Sounds ominous. Tracker Melas indicated you knew of a confrontation, yeah.
Tracker Melas indicated that you knew of a confrontation between Dr. Hoon Forsh and the Constable.
Yes, the Doctor mentioned it when she asked about Aramet. He's a Ferengi who provides us with alien species for the Preserve.
Right.
Was she inquiring about mistagged animals from his shipment?
Yes, she had spoken to Zudan, one of the three watchers in charge of the last shipment. He told her to talk to Aramet.
How can we talk to these watchers? The watchers requested restricted species and were denied. Did the other watchers also tell her to speak to Aramet?
Did the other watchers also tell her to speak to Aramet?
I doubt it. The other watchers were at the quarantine shelter and suffered some kind of neural energy drain when the generators exploded. They've been comatose ever since. Zudan's the only watcher on duty now.
So there are more than just animals suffering from neural energy drain.
We have found several animals which suffered energy drains. Perhaps we could compare neuroscans to see if the injuries are similar.
I'll send you the watcher's neuroscans. You can view them on the bio table, but I recommend you speak to Watcher Zudan. You can find him at the quarantine shelter.
Oh. Will he be there now? On several occasions, the Watchers requested restricted species and were denied.
On several occasions, the Watchers requested restricted species and were denied. Is it possible that Aramet was secretly supplying the Watchers with illegal species?
Aramet has a rather unsavory reputation. Hmm. The Watchers wouldn't have anything to do with someone like that. But you can ask Zudan yourself.
Did Consultant Idia know of Aramut's reputation when he recommended him for a traitor?
Considering how long Idia and Aramet have known each other, I would think so. Those two go back quite a while.
Huh.
I think Idia even came here on Aramet's ship.
Interesting. Well, I can't stand this Idia guy. Maybe it's him behind it all. In with it with Aramet.
Thank you for your time.
Certainly. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Idia was the last to see Dr. Hoon Forsh before she disappeared. Idia is friends with a Ferengi, and Ferengi traitors are not known for their honor. Perhaps Idia is guilty.
Perhaps. Or it could be a dead end, a false lead.
The Watchers suffered an electrical energy drain from their neural pathways, like the Myocordae mole. The Watchers suffered an elect...
Oh, that's what that does, okay.
No unusual readings. I do not believe that will work. I do not believe that will work.
Use bioscans, well...
We should speak with Zudan.
Right.
Zudan's a keeper of the Preserve. He must have heard about the smuggling. And I'd be curious to see what else he knows.
I'd like to hear what Zudan knows about Dr. Hoon Forsh, as well as the situation in the Preserve.
I believe we should interview Watcher Zudan. He may have had contact with Dr. Hoon Forsh.
Okay. I guess there's nothing else to do with this. We can't take it. We looked at it. We analyzed it. I don't suppose.
It's not working. It's not working.
No. Okay. All right, in that case, let's go. Off to the quarantine shelter. Ah! Now there's someone here.
It's Watcher Zudan.
Watcher Zudan does not appear as aggressive as Constable Lixi.
That's good.
Watcher Zudan seems very committed to his work.
Oh, we're very proud of Watcher Zudan.
Zudan is one of three Watchers who were responsible for the second shipment of preserve animals.
Hail, and well met. Greetings, traveler. Gonna walk all the way around. What, so we could stand there and talk to Watcher Zudan? I don't see any way for us to get down there. We just have to get closer. Can we yell from where we are? And there's no way to, like, speed this up. You know, if I double-click, it should, like, speed him there. That would be a great thing. But no. And where are you going? Down. Oh, and you're going to come through there? Interesting. Huh. I didn't know that.
I'm Lieutenant Commander Data of the Starship Enterprise. I'm investigating the absence of Dr. Hoon-Forsch.
I'm responsible for preserve animals, not Federation scientists.
That's nice.
I understand the doctor spoke to you of her concerns regarding smuggling in the preserve.
Yes, she came here soon after the outages, ranting away. Imagine, accusing me, when I'm the one who told her about that boar mistagging.
Hmm. Yeah, what creature was in this area?
What creature was in this area?
A 2-meter-long, 180-kilogram Sultis reptile, which came in on the last shipment. I found the Watchers next to its cage the night of the outages. It's still missing.
My readings show traces of a tranquilizing agent in its waste.
Hmm.
Aramut always doses his animals with neurotranquilizers, just like Idia. We had to feed the reptile intravenously for days. It finally woke up right before the accident, just in time to escape.
So that's that ionic residue or whatever we found around here?
These readings share the same ionic residue as samples found near other creatures drained of electrical energy. And this cage is also next to the drain generator. Perhaps the Sultis reptile is a mistagged animal that consumes electrical energy.
Right. Okay, I was right about ionic residue, but it's electrical energy, not have anything to do with tranquilizers.
But there were no reports of it being seen near any of the power outages, and that reptile isn't easy to miss. Unless it's found a way to turn itself invisible, you're going to need another theory.
Maybe it is invisible. Maybe it's right next to us, about to devour us whole.
We have encountered several species capable of phasing out of the time continuum and, in effect, becoming invisible. We have also encountered species who consumed human neural energy. The Sultis reptile may be a life form with similar characteristics.
Hmm. Then couldn't it just phase out of the cage instead of destroying it?
Well, if you believe so, I suppose it's possible.
Hmm. When did you last see the doctor?
When did you last see Dr. Hoon-Forsch?
I haven't seen her for some time. I've been busy recovering animals which escaped during the power outages. It's not easy work. The last time I saw her, I sent her to talk to Aramut.
Hmm. Were you the one who found the carcass?
Were you the one who found the carcass?
Yes. It died just before the outages, and I wanted her to test it.
Why didn't you ask Idia?
Why did you not ask Consultant Idiot to test the carcass?
I don't trust him. Hmm. Always drugging and borrowing animals for his experiments.
Really?
In the interests of science, he says. I don't know how he could have approved that mistagging in the first place.
This guy kind of reminds me of an Elcor, the way he talks. Elcor from Mass Effect.
Did the Watcher's stunner set off the preserve surveillance system?
The system only detects signs of distress. Normal sleep does not raise an alarm. Likewise, stunners and neurotranquilizers also don't alert the system. Unlike Idia and Aramet, we prefer stunners. Chemical sedation can be harmful.
Hmm.
Consultant Idia mentioned that only Watchers can change the ID tags.
That's true. But the suppliers tag the animals first. We just match them up with the constable's shipping orders. Idia is responsible for verifying them.
Is it true that the Watchers' requests for restricted species were rejected?
Only 4 species out of 112.
112?
Of course, we were upset at first. But once the preserve is completed, we can always try again.
Hmm. I have examined the neuroscans of the injured Watchers. Right.
I have examined the neuroscans of the injured Watchers. The electrical energy within their neural pathways has decreased significantly. How could that have happened?
I don't know. During my evening rounds, I found them unconscious next to the Saltus reptile cage. I carried them outside the shelter and was going for help when the generators exploded.
Hmm.
Thank you for your time.
Watch your step now.
Idia persuaded the constable to use Aramut. And Idia is also capable of verifying mistagged species. And he had the neurotranquilizers to knock out Dr. Hunforsch if she posed a threat to him.
Right.
Only stunners or drugs could disable someone without setting off the surveillance systems. Idia has a supply of neurotranquilizers.
Hmm. Looks like we found our man.
Have you located any escaped creatures?
Can you come back another time? I'm trying to locate some of those escaped creatures, and I can't afford to be distracted.
Okay. As we start using the consoles. Now, I could have the others talk to him, but I don't think there's going to be anything different, and we'll have to wait till for each of them to walk down there, so no thanks. Not unless it appears at some point that we have to do so.
I do not believe that will work.
Alright, what do we have to say?
We should take our evidence to Constable Lixie.
We must speak with Constable Lixie. She should hear what we have discovered.
Aye, indeed.
We should take our...
What are we missing? Crusher.
I'd like to see how Constable Lixie reacts to what we've discovered.
Licky.
I believe we now have sufficient evidence to explain the doctor's disappearance. We should present it to Constable Lixie.
Saving. Another 2-in-1 episode. Or our first, actually. 3-in-1 if we don't get this solved. How do we... Damn it. Our sojourn has been long and, weariful. Wearying. Tiring. Hey, Licky. Guess what we found out.
I believe Consultant Idia is involved with smuggling rare species into the preserve.
Are you trying to pick up where Dr. Hunforsch left off? She accused nearly everyone else of the same thing.
Well, we're not accusing everyone else. Just him, baby. Just him.
Idia persuaded you to hire a trader with a questionable reputation and knowingly verified mistagged animals. Idia also uses neurotranquilizers, which he could have used to stun the doctor without triggering your surveillance systems.
Mm-hmm.
Idia's been nothing but trouble since he got here. This time he's gone too far.
Oh.
I'll send for him so we can settle this once and for all.
Starting to be persuaded, actually. Oh!
Please wait here until Constable Lixie returns.
Okie dokie. So how are you doing?
Visitors for Constable Lixie.
Yes, she is present. Hello? Where is he? Oh.
Constable, we asked Consultant Idia to go to your office. He went to get some items, then suddenly beamed out. He seems to be gone.
Huh.
He must have called Aramid for help. The Ferengi has a subspace transporter. See if you can find Dr. Hunforsch.
There's a woman here asleep with a gag over her mouth. Maybe she knows.
Oh, yeah, she probably knows she's Dr. Hunforsch or whatever.
That's her, you idiot. Wake her and send her here. And have a look around Idia's office while you're there. He might have left some evidence.
That's right, you idiot. Oh yeah, just look all around and around. Oh boy, oh dizzy, I can't take it. Oh yeah, yeah, what a world, what a world.
There's no need for that.
So. Nice day. Oh.
Have you captured Idia?
That's her, isn't it?
No. Unfortunately, he escaped with Aramut. This Federation team was sent to find you. Perhaps they can help.
Perhaps.
I'm Dr. Beverly Crusher of the Enterprise. Don't worry, we'll find Idia and Aramut.
Forget them. We have to recapture the Mistag Sultis. It's already killed dozens of animals and destroyed several containment field generators.
So where would we find that thing? In the bog area, right? That's where all the neural things... Damaged animals are in the bog area, if I remember right.
You have to capture this creature before it does any more damage. Have the quarantine shelter generators been repaired?
The shelter force field will not help us. The creature escaped once, and it will escape again.
Phasers on maximum kill.
Maybe you could rephase the force field somehow. That might be enough to stop the creature.
That might work. But the only place we can rephase the force field power is at the main power grid.
Which is where?
I'll go rephase the force fields.
Good. The power grid is on the other side of the preserve. Take one of the shuttles.
Oh, back to the shuttle, Doc.
I hate to interrupt, but just how are we supposed to lure this creature back to the shelter?
I was just wondering the same exact thing. And plus, where is it? Emitting high energy EM fields, or channel as much energy as we can. Yeah. That's nice, but that won't help if we can't lure it, so let's use this as bait.
The harmonic collector can emit high energy EM fields. Let's use that as the bait.
Yes, that should do it. V, I'll send one of the watchers with you to the shelter to help set it up. If we can get the field power rephased, we might get that thing under control. I'll stay and monitor the situation from here.
Okay. We can't actually talk to her? Guess not.
Visitors for Constable Lixie. Constable Lixie is present.
Oh, goody.
Back to the shelter. Not shelter. Shuttle, Doc. Okay. I kind of feel like charging our thing just in case while we're here. If we still have it. Oh, we didn't take it off. Hopefully we won't need it. I left it on one of those things. I left it at the marine one. Damn it. Alright, board shuttle. we go. Utilities network.
This is the utilities distribution network. We can control the electricity from here.
Mm-hmm. Utilities trunk. I'm gonna walk over to it and screen.
The utilities trunk directs the field energy to waveguide conduit networks.
It looks like he's looking right at us and saying that.
We did not come here for sightseeing.
Oh my.
Hmm.
She doesn't know what to make of it.
Worf is the ship's security.
Not him.
This is a utilities trunk which controls the field energy within waveguide conduit networks.
In other words,
This is the utilities distribution network. It controls the allocation of resources in the preserve, including electricity.
Mm-hmm.
Lieutenant Worf.
Worf again.
Intriguing.
Intriguing.
The utility trunk controls the field energy distribution to the waveguide conduit networks.
There's nothing unusual here. There's nothing unusual here.
Is there something unusual here? Let's all go over.
The utilities trunk controls field energy within waveguide conduit networks.
Okay, so we... I don't want to look at that. Do we use it from here, then? Actually, yeah. Hello?
The energy fields are responding. Frequency phasing complete.
Constable, has the harmonic collector been arranged?
Yes, but Dr. Hunforsch needs your help with the quarantine shelter. The only watchers I could find are needed to oversee the other biotopes.
Okay.
We will be there.
Just one more thing. Zudan tells me those generators won't hold up for long, and we can't afford to send much power to the shelter right now. Many biotopes are already on reserve power only.
Okay.
We will review the situation at the shelter when we arrive. Where will you be?
I'll be controlling electrical systems from my office. Then I have to call an emergency meeting of the Marassian Constabulary to explain just what's going on.
Huh. Interesting.
I do not believe that will work. I do not believe that will work.
Alright, so we're leaving. That was quick. How do we get out of here again? Greetings.
It is Dr. V. Hunforsch.
It's Dr. Hunforsch.
It is Dr. Hunforsch.
Is it Dr. Hunforsch?
It's Dr. Hunforsch.
Nah.
I'd be glad to help. Is the trap ready?
Thanks so much for talking from there and not walking all the way around and down.
It's all set up. But I need you to operate those consoles while I keep an eye on the creature from here.
All right. What should I do?
The harmonic collector's hooked into console 2. Once activated, it'll emit high-energy pulses to lure the creature in.
Hmm.
All right. What should I do?
The harmonic collector's hooked in...
All right, let's save. Have to do it just right, otherwise I won't save over. Okay. So we want to do... not talk to console 2, but use it. Now what?
What is the next step?
Once the creature gets here, close the gates. The controls are on console 1.
Okay. Which is here. it's a flying thing? Can't just fly out of here?
What is the next step?
Console 3?
Quickly. Activate the containment field, console 3.
Well, if I hadn't asked you, you wouldn't even told me I had to do it. Take that, you flibbin' schniggin' schmuggin'. We caught the ghost in the containment trap.
We did. Yay. Now what took you so long to find me?
You were missing. Disappeared. You went bye-bye.
The investigation was actually quite short in duration. Apparently your absence was not keenly felt. Constable Lixey had attributed your absence to a field trip.
Yeah, in other words, no one really gave a crap about you. Sorry.
She was probably still upset that I accused her of smuggling. I suppose I should apologize to her, now that I know Idia was behind the whole thing.
How did Consultant Idia learn that you suspected him? Did you accuse him of smuggling as well?
I didn't confront him. I was just looking for information. But after I asked him about the Sultis, he must have panicked and decided to drug me. I should have suspected when he invited me to dinner. He hates to hear people talk while he eats.
Oh my god, that guy's even more of a creep now that I hear her talking about it. I mean, we know she... Well, do we know he drugged her? No, he bound her, gagged her. So he invited you to dinner and drugged him, you know. You should always have the bartender give you the drinks.
It appears the Watchers knew nothing of Idia's scheme to smuggle rare animals into the preserve through Aramut.
They were the ones who brought the Mistag boar to my attention in the first place. They weren't smuggling anything.
Right.
Apparently, Consultant Idia underestimated this reptile's appetite for electrical energy.
Yeah, I'd say.
That egotist, thinking he could get away with it. Some of these animals are even from Romulan space. Did he think I wouldn't notice?
Yeah, maybe.
Are you certain the animals are Romulan in origin?
It would take more tests to be certain, but they definitely came from Romulan space. It's not surprising. Aramut does a lot of trading along the neutral zone.
What will happen to this reptile?
I'm sure Constable Lixey will want to send it back, unless I can convince her to keep it here. A creature like that doesn't come by every day.
It's too dangerous.
I believe the captain will want to pursue Idia and Aramut. Will this incident significantly delay completion of the preserve?
It'll be a little behind schedule, but I have a few suggestions to help them speed things up.
Well, that's good.
Then it is time we return to the Enterprise. Good luck, Doctor. Beam us up.
Captain's log supplemental. Our successful attempt to locate Dr. Hunforsch has uncovered another mystery. Apparently, the creature responsible for the chaos on Marassia may have come from Romulan space.
Indeed.
We are currently searching for the Ferengi trader Aramut. Despite somewhat questionable trading practices, he has never violated Federation law. Until now.
Captain, Tabak asks to speak with you.
Captain, I heard about what happened on Marassia. That creature you discovered.
How'd you hear?
It sounds exactly like a Varanak.
Varanak?
A Caridian creature. Except the Varanak was exterminated long ago.
Maybe not completely?
How could a Ferengi trader get hold of an extinct animal?
He went back in time?
I have a theory. The followers brought many animals with them when they fled Gerid. It may be that this creature came from the followers' colony.
So if we learn where he got the animal, we may learn where the fifth scroll is.
Oh, it's all tying together, isn't it?
I think this is a promising lead to pursue.
Captain, we've found Aramut. A Ferengi trader should be at Jaward 3.
Jaward 3?
Set a course for the Jaward system.
Well, we're going right there. I was about to call it an episode. And I'm gonna do so. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time. And endure. And enduring, grow strong.